couldn't do the programme if I didn't enjoy it. I mean, I quite often get letters from people who think that I'm faking it all. You know, an old birth like you can't possibly like young people's music. And that's an attitude that I can entirely understand, because I'd probably have felt the same way when I was a kid if some 41-year-old bloke, old enough to be my dad, had claimed to like Gene Vincent. But the fact is that I do like it, and I suppose it's this terrible naivety and stupidity that enables me to do the job that I do tolerably well. It comes down to being a fan, really, I suppose. I mean, I worship Liverpool FC, and I feel the same about The Undertones or The Fall or Misty as I do about Kenny Dalglish. I just wish that there were more people playing the sort of music that I play. Distant cries of, are you kidding? But with a lot of the records, it's just a fact that if I don't play them, they don't get played on the radio at all. And what I really need is about 5 hours a night, 7 days a week, and then perhaps I could really do justice to the thing.
Could you tell me the names of some of the groups that you had on the programme who then went on to become well-known?
Well, there have been hundreds of them. Well, not hundreds, but there have been a great many of them over the years. Some I'm a bit embarrassed to talk about. I mean, bands like Yes, Jethro Tull. I mean, we're talking about, obviously, 12 years ago. Although in the pages of the Sunday Times, they live on. I don't know, Roxy Music and people like this. The Slits. I don't know, really. I should have worked out a list of them. But there have been quite a few, to be honest, over the years. But it puts me in an invidious position, because I don't seek to be in a position of power. You know, it's not something that I actually want, but it's a position that I'm in, unfortunately. And I don't like that aspect of it at all.
Schooling at 15 and a half, and we decided to make our own record on an independent label with our own money. And then one evening I heard it on the radio, and I got my first ego trip ever, sort of thing, listening to myself on the radio. And then it suddenly started playing it every night, and we became quite in vogue on the John Peel show. So we decided to come down to London, where we met, and we came to our first ever concert in London. And I think he actually got in touch with Virgin Records to come along and see us. And they did come along, and we got a session through. And henceforth, we had a hit single, and we've sort of climbed up the ladder, slowly but surely, with the initial help of John Peel.
It's the only radio show that has new artists, and that's what I... we're looking for.
How do you use it?
I record it, and the next day I'll come into the office and listen to it through, write down the records that I've heard that I like, go down the road to Rough Trade and buy them.
And so, I mean, what would you say to people who said you ought to go out and see the bands?
I do too, you know, but there's many, many bands in the country, and you get some idea of what they're like if you hear them on the show, and then you go and see them afterwards. You know, if you hear something, you're going to go and see them as soon as possible.
Do other A&R men in other record companies use the
show? I would think that most A&R men listen to it.
And is there anything comparable?
No.
I mean, he doesn't play the skids so much now, because we've got people maybe in the daytime playing this now. But that's through his assistance, of course. But, I mean, there's all these young bands. We get the records played in John Peel, and obviously Jumbo's heard it, and a few other Ian Army might help them. And they're due for corruption soon. Due to be corrupted by big business.